Our Chicago is a city of many cultures and many nationalities, and within its limits are certain neighborhoods and communities that have managed to retain a certain flavor of other lands. Now, we have Chicago clubs whose members trace their ancestry back to Ireland and Italy and Germany and Scandinavia and Poland. And most of these Chicagoans glory in their heritage. They're proud of the history of the land of their forefathers, and they cherish its heritage and culture. And often, they form associations and clubs and community centers to keep alive that heritage and culture. Now, I'd like to tell you about one such association and of what you might call a study in reverse migration. This is Chicago's Near North Side, the intersection of LaSalle and Kinzie, and it's here that we find the headquarters of the All Tribes American Indian Center. About 4 years ago, the Department of the Interior launched a relocation program. It encourages Indian families to leave the poverty of reservations and to come to cities where work is to be had. At the All Tribes Center, they find a ready welcome from the representatives of all of the Indian nations. In addition to help finding jobs, the newcomers have the opportunity to continue developing the skills acquired from parents or other members of the tribe. To these migrants and to the 3,500 Indians who now call Chicago home, the center is a club, a recreation area, a school, and a place to secure help with problems. Children play a vital part in the scheme of things. Here they receive instruction in a variety of subjects, including handicraft, sports, and Indian lore. Sunday is an especially festive day. Open house, and the whole family may drop in for the afternoon. There are books for the asking, television, and the teepee was never like this, and a good fast session of checkers. What I said about the center being a family place is no joke. Mom and baby too come right along. You know, it's interesting to consider that Chicago's Indians come from more than 40 different tribes across the nation, but despite the many tribal differences, they somehow manage to find a singleness of identity when they gather for one of the traditional dances. Now let's meet some of the choreographers, Benjamin Bearskin, a Winnebago Sioux, and Eli Paulus of the Oneida tribe. It's hard to believe they're in Chicago in the year 1955. Now suppose that we turn up the volume and tune in on music that was old when our nation was born. Has to go out west to see an Indian ritual dance.